Hello everyone, welcome back to Cinta DIY. And today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet the strip glove, which is really easy and simple and fast to make. Okay, now let's get into the video. For making this glove, I'm using only one hook. It is 4.5mm hook. First, we are going to make the ribbing around the wrist. To begin, make a slip knot. And chain 14. It is equal 2.5 inches length. If you guys want the ribbing part higher, please add more chains. After you got 14 chains, next we are going to make single crochet. For row 1, skip 1 chain and make single crochet into the second chain. To make single crochet, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 2 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 2 loops. Keep repeating this into every chain until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, next for row 2, chain 1, turn your work, and we are going to make single crochet but into the back loop of the stitch only. Keep making single crochet back loop only into every stitch until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, for the next row, we are going to repeat row 2 until you reach row 23. It is equal 6 inches length. It's the size around my wrist. If you guys want it bigger, please add more rows. And this is what the ribbing part looks like after you reach row 23. And I recommend that for the ribbing part at the wrist, you don't have to make it too fit, just make it a little bit tight on your wrist because the ribbing stitch is stretching. So you want your glove a little bit tight on your hand. Next, turn the ribbing part face together and we are going to make single crochet both sides together. Continue from where your last stitch is and insert the hook into the other side loop. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. Then insert the hook into both sides loop. Yarn over and pull through the loops. And now you have two loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. Keep repeating this into every stitch until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row and here what it looks like. Next, we are going to make single crochet around the ribbing panel. For row 1, chain 1 and make single crochet into the stitch near chain 1. For this first single crochet, it is where we are going to make slip stitch at the end of the row. Keep making single crochet into this stitch until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make slip stitch into this first single crochet stitch. To make slip stitch, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull through all the loops. Next, for row 2, chain 2, turn your work, and we are going to make half double crochet. Skip this first stitch and make half double crochet into the next stitch. To make half double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. Keep repeating this into the next 2 stitches. After you got 3 stitches of half double crochet, then we are going to make increase by make 2 half double crochet into the same stitch. After you got 2 half double crochet into the same stitch, Then keep repeating the same thing by make 3 half double crochet and then increase around until you have one last stitch. Then I will meet you back again. After you had one last stitch remain, then we are going to make increase into that last stitch. For the last stitch, we are going to change the color. After you got 3 loops on your hook, then drop the purple yarn and grab the white yarn. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. And this is how we change the color. Next, make slip stitch into the chain 2 stitch. Next, for row 3, chain 2, turn your work, and we are going to make half double crochet into this stitch. First, don't forget to cut off the purple yarn. Keep making half double crochet into every stitch around until you have one last stitch. Then we are going to change the color again. After you have changed the color, then make slip stitch into the chain 2 stitch. Next, for row 4, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into every stitch until you have one last stitch, then change the color and make slip stitch. 4 row 5, repeat row 3. After you reach the end of the row, then for row 6 until row 8, chain 2, turn your work and make half double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row, then make slip stitch into the chain 2 stitch. After you got 3 rows of purple yarn, then for the last stitch of row 8, we are going to change the color and make slip stitch into the chain 2 stitch. Next, for row 9, repeat row 3. After you reach row 9, for row 10, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into every stitch until you have 6 last stitches, then I will meet you back again. After you have 6 last stitches remain, then fold the gloves like this. Make the purple color face to each other. You can try this on your hand to see what it looks like. So for this part that we make slip stitch, should place on the palm. And for the 6 stitches that we skip, it is the measurement that we keep for the thumb. After you have 6 last stitches remain, then chain 3 and make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the next row, we are going to make another white color. Turn your work and attach the yarn into the stitch where we made slip stitch. For row 11, chain 2 and make half double crochet into the same stitch with chain 2. Then make 3 half double crochet into this chain 3 space. Next, continue make half the ball crochet into every stitch around until you have one last stitch, then change the color and make slip stitch. Next, for row 12 until row 15, chain 2, turn your work, and make half the ball crochet into every stitch until the end of the row, then make slip stitch. After you got 4 rows of half the ball crochet, next, for row 16, make single crochet into every stitch around, then make slip stitch, chain 1 and cut off the yarn. You can try this on your hand to see what it looks like. If you guys want it longer, please add more rows. If you want it shorter, please make less row. For the next part, we are going to make single crochet around the thumb part. To begin, attach the yarn into the stitch where we made slip stitch. For row 1, chain 1 and make single crochet into every stitch until the end of the row, then make slip stitch. For row 2 until row 3, chain 1, turn your work, and make single crochet into every stitch until the end of the row, then make slip stitch. After you got 3 rows of single crochet, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, use darning needle to weave in. And now you are done for the right glove. Next, for the left glove, we are repeat the same thing like the right glove until you reach row 9, and we have a little bit different at row 10. For row 10, chain 1, turn your work, and make single crochet into the next 2 stitches. After you got 2 single crochet, then chain 3. Next, skip 6 stitches. It is the measurement for the thumb and also the same size like the right thumb. After you have skipped 6 stitches, then make single crochet into the 7th stitch. Keep making single crochet around until you have 1 last stitch, then we are going to change the color and make slip stitch. For the next row, start from row 11 until row 16. We are going to repeat the same thing like the right glove. Thank you. After you reach row 16, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the thumb part, we are going to repeat the same thing like the right thumb. And now the strip glove is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.